one right along. Good morning, everybody. I want to start by just acknowledging the amazing contribution of the community in coming forward for vaccinations. Yesterday in New South Wales, we had the biggest number of vaccinations in our state, New South Wales state vaccination hubs, than we've ever had. 61,778 people came forward to our state hubs. In addition, there were another 94,387 people who attended either at a GP or a pharmacist. So we had a total yesterday in New South Wales alone of 156,165 people received a jab. So again, thank you to all of our residents who've come forward for a vaccination. As we've said many times, vaccination is a critical path out of our current situation. Yesterday, there were also 1,035 locally acquired cases of COVID in the period up to 8 p.m. last night. There was also one overseas case. Thankfully, many people came forward for tests as well, and there were 129,182 tests undertaken yesterday up to 8 p.m. So again, thank you to all of our community in New South Wales who are coming forward whenever they have any symptoms at all, any flu-like symptoms, cold-like symptoms, or if they've been exposed to the virus, a close contact of a virus, or they've been asked to by the New South Wales public health team. Sadly, very sadly, we had two people pass away to 8 p.m. last night. One was a lady in her 70s from the Sydney Nepean Blue Mountains district, and she passed away at Nepean Hospital. There was also a lady in her 80s from Western Sydney, and she passed away at Westmead Hospital. I want to express obviously my sympathies and the sympathies of the entire New South Wales health system and our government to the families of those two ladies. It's a terrible situation, and to have any loved one pass away at any time is obviously challenging, but in this COVID situation I think many of us are feeling it even more. In addition, I want to just raise some details in regard to the far western region of New South Wales. There were four new cases in the far west of the state to 8 p.m. last night. All four of those were in Wilcannia. This means that we now have a total of 69 cases in that far west local health district. And I just remind everybody that I think the totals are now 58 in Wilcannia, 6 in Broken Hill, and one case has now left that area and gone to Queensland. The western New South Wales area, which is obviously somewhat closer towards Sydney, there have been 42 new cases of COVID-19 reported to 8 p.m. last night, and this brings the total cases in that western New South Wales area to 495 cases. 34 of those cases that were reported to 8 p.m. last night were in Dubbo, 6 cases were in Bourke, 1 was in Bathurst, and 1 is in Mudgee. There is some positive news in Dubbo today, which I'll just highlight too, and that is that we have the first drive-through vaccination clinic opening in Dubbo today, and that'll also be at the showground. I'm sure locals know exactly where that is. Some other issues I just want to address before I hand over to Dr. McAnulty. Obviously, the circumstances in New South Wales are such that whilst we're seeing massive vaccination numbers, we're also seeing substantial cases. And for a number of weeks now, we've had no capacity for people to get married. A decision has been taken that it's in a balanced sense, we have to be able to allow people who want to get married to get married. So as from 12:01 a.m. Friday this coming week, couples who wish to marry will be able to marry, but with minimal guests in attendance. So there'll be 5 guests allowed, in addition to those who obviously will be necessary for the actual service. So those officiating and perhaps a photographer to record the event, but we'll work through that during the course of the week. But I just want people to know that if you do wish to get married, you certainly can as of Friday this week. Another issue which is concerning the health team is that there is a lot of misinformation being put out in social media. And one of the big concerns is women who want to have a child, couples who want to have a child, the misinformation is certainly around deterring people from effectively having a child by or having a vaccination, one or the other, by suggesting that there's some negative aspects of being vaccinated in terms of your fertility. Can I just confirm that the most senior health advisory service in Australia has confirmed absolutely that there is no evidence whatsoever that a woman's fertility, for that matter a man's fertility, would be in any way affected by having the vaccine. A strong point though that was made to me when I was inquiring about the evidence is that particularly young women and girls who are contemplating having a child should understand that if they don't have the vaccine and they do get the virus, they may suffer from long COVID or from symptoms that would actually make it more difficult to be able to have children and to have as many children as they'd like. So I think the strong message here is don't believe what you're seeing in the social media. Don't believe what's on some of these sites that indicate that the vaccines will cause any difficulty in getting pregnant. It certainly won't. In fact, it is precisely the opposite. I also want to address an issue around ambulances, and I'm joined here today by Commissioner Morgan from the New South Wales Ambulance, who have some more to say on this issue. But it's very frustrating at a time when we are getting obviously very substantial numbers of people who need New South Wales health assistance. They need to come to hospital, that there are quite a number of people who are effectively using ambulances as taxis. Ambulances are not taxis. They are meant for emergencies. I think that we all need to understand that if you call an ambulance when you really don't need an ambulance, when it's not an emergency, someone else who may really need that ambulance could well suffer, could well die. So Commissioner Morgan will have a little to say about that and the pressures also that our ambulance service is currently under. Finally, I just want to explain to particularly to the media, but also to the broader community, the reason why we are outside this building here today, which is the health headquarters in New South Wales, is that like every other possible venue in New South Wales at the present time, it is the case that you could expect at some time to have a positive case come into your building or the area where you are. I think Premier has said many times, just work on the basis that the people who you're coming into contact with have COVID. That's the safest way to be at the present time. This building had a cleaner enter the building on the 24th, 25th and 26th of August while she was positive. And the building is currently in the relevant parts. The relevant parts, a very big building, of course. The relevant parts are subject to having a deep clean. And for that reason, we are outside. I'm going to ask Dr. McAnulty to give us more information in regard to cases. I'm going to ask Susan Pearce, who is the Deputy Secretary, to talk about our vaccination program. And then I'm going to ask Commissioner Dominic Morgan to talk about some of the challenges for our ambulance service at the present time, and particularly to ask the community to be on board with us in trying to keep ambulances for emergencies. So first of all, Dr. Jeremy McAnulty.
Thanks very much, Minister, and good morning, everyone. There were 1,035 locally acquired cases of COVID-19 reported in New South Wales to 8 o'clock last night, and one case who was acquired overseas. We're still seeing fantastic testing numbers with 129,182 tests performed to 8 o'clock last night, compared to the previous day total of over 118,000. We have a large number of people in hospital. 778 patients with COVID are currently in hospital. 125 of those are in intensive care, and 52 require ventilation. There's quite a few young people in their 20s and 30s who are requiring intensive care therapy. And of the 125 in intensive care, 110 are not vaccinated, 14 have had one dose of vaccine, and one person has had two doses of vaccine. There is a health worker in Westmead intensive care who's been vaccinated. And it just stresses the importance that a vaccine is very effective in reducing severe disease, but it's not 100%. We all need to protect our health workers who are on the front line caring for us all in the community. To protect them, we need not only healthcare workers to be vaccinated, but all of us to be vaccinated as soon as we can. By getting vaccinated, you're reducing the chance that you'll get vaccine, but also pass it on to other people, as well as having severe outcomes like hospitalisation and even death. So please, please help protect our frontline workers. Sadly, there have been two deaths, as the Minister mentioned yesterday. A woman in her 70s from Sydney's Nepean Blue Mountains district who died at Nepean Hospital after acquiring infection there earlier this month. This is a fourth death linked to the outbreak of the hospital. She'd received two doses of COVID vaccine and also had some serious underlying diseases. A woman in her 80s from Western Sydney also has died at Westmead Hospital. She was not vaccinated. And we extend our deepest sympathy to the family and friends of these two people. There have now been 83 COVID-related deaths in New South Wales since the 16th of June, and 139 in total for the pandemic. We continue to be very concerned about southwestern and western Sydney cases escalating, and particularly in the suburbs of Guildford, Merrylands, Auburn, Granville, Bankstown and Grey Staines. So wherever we are in the state, of course, assume that you might be at risk of COVID, but in those areas in the southwestern and western Sydney in particular, be very aware of the COVID safe behaviours to follow. We've also seen a number of sewage surveillance test positive in the country areas where we haven't identified cases at this point. So we've got ongoing surveillance of sewage, which is very effective in identifying a positive the virus that causes COVID. So we've seen that yesterday in Brewarrina, Moree, Marimbula, Barradine and Bonnie Hills. So we're just urging people in those communities to come forward for testing if you have even the mildest of symptoms. It's just so important that we find cases in these areas so we can help.